Hi everyone, welcome back. So what we will do is we'll just do one step forward. We will try to look into the documentation of Sequelize and we will try to see how to define a schema model and what all different things we can do on top of it, like we can do the data validations, we can create a hooks in that schema model, and what all different methods we can execute on top of schema model object. So before we'll just do a little practice of the code. So here earlier we were writing some, inserting some users. So now what I'm doing is I'm just doing a bulk create of user, and then I'm just doing a bulk create of posts in my system. So like I will be creating 100 users and then I will be creating one single post. So you can see that posts has been created. Inside the posts you can see the user ID, right? So this is how we are defining the relationships, because user has a one-to-one relationship with the posts. We can change it to has many. So what in this case, what will happen, user can have multiple posts. It means multiple posts can have the user ID in them. So the only challenge is whenever I'm running this, sometimes it is failing because it is unable to truncate the relationship. So we need to drop this manually, because this need to be fixed in your process, in your migrations which you will be writing in future. Right, so now same thing happened. Now we can see the relationships and all. Post is again having user ID, right? So in this case now, user can be writing multiple posts, right? So this is how we can define the relationship, basic level of relationship. What we'll do is we'll just try to look at the Sequelize documentation. So getting started, it has all these things. I have checked that setting up the MySQLs, the data types. First, we will talk about the data types, what all different data types it is supporting. So there is a data types mapping. So whatever we are defining, string number, it has a mapping with the MySQL database. So you can see, most of the database supports the same generic types. So string is mapped with the varchar 255, string 1234 is mapped with the 1234, string binary is a varchar binary. When you have alphanumeric data, integer is integer, bigint is bigint. All this is actually a mapping of types, whatever you are defining in the Sequelize with the MySQL, what it is going to be. Okay, and while defining actually the schema model, we can define the types also. So we have seen it, right? A name. So name is of type Sequelize string. So you can just define that in the object, that type will be Sequelize string. And if you wanted to make it as anything else, then you can add attributes here. So attributes, we can get it from here. Model definitions. In model definition, what all we can do is you can define the type, you can define the comments, descriptions. Type is sequelize.integer. Similarly, what all fields will be indexed, which one is the primary key, like you can use the default value type and allow null, false, true. These are two additional argument you can add. So name, right? I don't want it to make name as default value is, let's default value put it TK Sharma, right? Allow null false means you have to enter this value. So this kind of validation will help us. You can also put if some value is unique, default value is to the current date, you can just do sequelize.now. If you wanted to make something as a primary key, then just put a primary key true, or sequelize integer, or increment true. So in every next row, it will get incremented, right? So timestamp and all, it gets generated using sequelize.now will give you the timestamp. Other than that, in the definition of any schema model, now let's take a look onto this. I'll just show you the code, what it is doing. So employee, right? Name is of type string, allow null false. These are the getter setter methods you can set, right? So I'm talking about the name type. This dot get default value title, okay? And what it is doing, whenever you try to get the name property from the employee schema model, then what it will give you, it will just add the name also and the title, right? So this allows you to access the attribute from that instance. And title also, if whenever you are setting the value of the title, what it will do, it will uppercase each and every. So whenever you are inserting something in the database, this particular column value, then it will always saved as a uppercase in database. Then you got the schema model object, employee.create, name and all these things you can do. We can play around with this, I think, get default value. So this is a schema model we have created. So let's put it here. Right, it's employee. So what we wanted to do, employee.create.then, let's put it in the chain. We don't need to do anything, it will be done, everything will be done from here. So we just need to put it inside a chain. So here we will have a dot then. If any error occurs, then you'll get to know. You don't need to worry about it. There is already catch defined. You can also define the catch for this particular block, because there is a promise, then dot then, and it requires catch also if something wrong happens here, right? So let's do this. So let me just check this again. What I'm doing, I'm just sequelize string, sequelize.define employee. You can use a particular case. Sequelize is not defined. What we are doing currently, connection.define, okay. You can see we got the uppercase letter, right? Senior engineer, John Doe, senior engineer. So title and value both has been retrieved. So here we are just doing a promise sending to retrieve the data. As we know, Sequelize is a promise based library. And you can see the employee collection has been created here. And again, you can just, if you wanted to define some relationship here, then you can just make employee has many posts or employee has many users. Employee and user are same kind of entity. So let's ignore that relationship, but employee can have multiple posts. So you can just do employee.has many posts. Okay. This is all. I mean, we can also look at the more documentation part, getter and setter, just to retrieve and set the value in the database. So it's like a kind of a hook you are creating. You want title always uppercase, so it is being taken care. Okay, now another part is, once you define these models, right, how you to define that model, Sequelize connection object, sequelize.define, your collection, I'm using collection every time. I will use this table name, project, which has a title and description, task, which has these attributes, right? So once you define the model with all these types, what is going to be unique, what is going to be null, is that a primary key, what is the default value, all these things, you can start executing the code something like this. So once you, like, you created an employee, right? So once the employee object is created, you can write the code something like this, user dot, what all methods it is supporting. Find all, find by ID, find by primary key, find and create, find, find one, find build, find create, all these things. What these methods are giving us the opportunity, it, we are actually doing nothing but we are doing query in the database. Find by ID, so it is actually do select star from user where ID equal to this, find one based on some where clues it is doing. Right, so all these documentation you can also see, it is explaining what it is actually doing. Okay, so we will take a look on to these in the next video.